Hi, Emily Kappel here again with MakingMathMakeSense.org. I've got my third grader Lucas and my kindergartner Chloe here with me. We're going to play a game called Go Fish Make 10. This game can be differentiated if your kiddo is not at the stage that they're making combinations to 10. You can work on making 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. Just make sure your deck of cards only has the numbers that can make combinations to yours. So I have adjusted our deck here. We're using cards from Boxcars and One Eyed Jacks. Because they have the 0, they have the 1, they have the 11 and the 12. I have not used the 11 and 12 yet with Chloe because we didn't want to work on subtraction going backwards. For this game, we're just going to add up to make 10. Now that she's done primping, we're each going to have 4 cards. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Here we go. So we're going to play Go Fish Make 10. So you're going to have a pond that you can go fish out of. I'm going to put that here in the middle. While we're all getting an initial look at our cards, we are seeing if we have any combinations to 10. So I know in my hand right now, I have a 1 and a 9. That's a combination to 10. So I'm going to pull that out and I'm going to take 2 more cards. Chloe and Lucas are busy pulling out their 10s as well. Yeah. Chloe also has a 9 and a 1. Lucas had a 6 and a 4 and a 5 and a 5. So we all laid out our combinations to 10 right now. And make sure you have 4 cards to start the game with. Chloe, since you're the youngest, you're going to go first, sweetheart.
Okay.
What do you need?
Hey, Mom, do you have a 1?
Do I have a 1? I do. Here you go. She must have had a what? Yeah, she had a 9. Good job. Lucas, your turn. I always tell my kiddos, make sure you have 4 cards in your hand so you have are working on mini combinations to 10.
Chloe, do you have a 9?
Oh, she did. Good job. Lucas, do you have a 4?
Go fish.
Go fish. Mom has to go fish in the pond. So now I have 5 cards in my hand. That's okay. I just have more combinations I'm trying to make.
Hey, Mom, do you have a 6?
I do. Chloe is making combinations to 10, and she's only in kindergarten. Her teachers are doing a rock star job. Like I said, I have done this game in a second grade class where I was going in weekly playing fluency games and testing their fluency through 10 and then up into the teens by the end of the year. I would have heterogeneous groupings. So I would have kids making different numbers. In a group with me, I might have one player making 6, a couple making 7, and somebody working on combinations to 9. If you only have one kiddo at home, you're only going to be working on that one number, maybe stretching them, maybe reviewing numbers that you know they already know the combinations to. Lucas, your turn.
Chloe, do you have a 3?
So it's like I said, just like the game Go Fish, the game ends when we have run out of cards, and then you're going to add up how many sets of 10s you have. Instead of just counting up the sets, you can also work on counting by 10. So 10, 20, 30, 40, which is a kindergarten skill, but a lot of our primary kiddos still need to be working on counting by 10s. Let us know in the comments below if you play this game, how you might change it, and how your kiddos like it. Thanks for stopping by again.